and then plus k minus 1. And for h, I can write aj xi to the power j, and this is equal to 0. So we have written our differential equation in this form, and now here, this xi j here, the xi is having power 1, and here the xi is having j minus 1. So 1 will cancel with 1 and xi j will be there. So we can take the xi j is common. So I can write that summation on j running from 0 to infinity, and this will be j plus 1 j plus 2 a j plus 2 minus 2 and j a j plus k minus 1 a j, and equal this will be xi j is common and equal to 0. Now, as we know that these are the coefficient and this is the variable, so the variable is non-zero. It means that all these coefficients are equal to 0. So I can write that j plus 1 into j plus 2 a j plus 2 minus 2j a j plus k minus 1 a j is equal to 0. And this I can write further that if I move this one the other side, so we will have plus 2j minus k minus 1 and aj. So this one, move that one the other side, so we will have 2j minus k minus 1 and divide by j plus 1 into j plus 2 and aj here, and this is equal to aj plus 2, and this we call the recursion relation. Because it is recurring the values. If I put j equal to 0, then I will start with a2, and for if I start j with an odd value like a1, then this will be a3. So for the even means a0, a2, a2, then a4, and so on, while for a1 I will get a3, then a3 here, I will get a5 here, and so on. So we have the recursion relation. The recursion relation, and it is equal to aj plus 2 is equal to 2j plus 1 minus k divided by j plus 1 into j plus 2 and aj. Now we can recover from this one our odd and even coefficients, and they are like, if I consider j equals 0, then I will have a2 equals to 0, 1 minus k, 1 minus k divide by 1 and 2, so 2 and a0. So I will have a0 here. Similarly, if j is equal to 2, so I will have A4 equal to 2 into 4 n plus 1, 5 minus k divided by 3 and 4. So we have 12 A2 and so on. So these are all, when we start from 0, then this is in a series of even coefficients of this series. And if I start with j equals 1, then I will get a 3 in terms of a 1. So for j equal to 1, we are having 2 plus 1, 3 minus k divided by 2 and 3. We are having 6 here in a 1. Similarly, a 5 will be when j is equal to 3, so we will have a 5, and this will be 7 minus k divided by 20, because 3 plus 1, 4 and 5, so 20, and this will be a 3 and so on, and this will be an odd series. So we will have for the h of xi, the h of xi even series and h of xi an odd series. It depends from which value we are starting. So we will have the h even series, the h of xi, the even series will be like a naught. Here is we had a naught plus a 2 xi square plus a 2 xi square plus a 4 xi 4 and so on. And the h xi odd series will be here a 1 xi, a 1 xi plus a 3 xi 3 plus a 5 xi 5 and so on. So we will have two series, and all of these are actually the solution of this differential equation. But we will have to note that all solutions are we say may not be normalizable. Means all solution may not be the quantum mechanical solutions. So, and the solutions, they are not ending, they are going like this here. So it's a combination of odd and even series, and they are not ending. But if we consider a harmonic oscillator, then inside a harmonic oscillator, the levels are not finishing, but we will have to put a limit somewhere for the maximum value of j, means how maximum we can go for j, how many discrete levels are quantized level we will have. So we will have to limit the value of j, and in order to limit this one, let's say I go back to the recursion relation and I say that aj, when it will be the maximum number of j plus 2, then I will say that I will not consider the coefficients beyond this value. So this will be equal to 0, means I will terminate the series. This series is going on, so I will terminate this series at some point means not go beyond that one, but only up to that. So to terminate this one, I consider the maximum value of J to be J maximum. And for J maximum, the coefficient should be equal to 0. If I write in above, AJ maximum plus 2, and if I consider that this is equal to 0, then this applies that the numerator of the recursion relation is to be 0. So this implies that 2j, and this will be j maximum plus 1 minus k into aj maximum is equal to 0. Now, as I know that this one is a coefficient, this will be not 0, so this is equal to 0, and I call this J maximum, this J maximum is n. So I will write that 2n, I will write this 2 and J maximum is 2n, 2n plus 1 minus k is equal to 0, and this implies that k is equal to 2n plus 1. So the k that I supposed earlier in the differential equation, I now got its value in the form of 2n plus 1. Remember that k was equal to 2e over h bar omega. So this implies that 2n plus 1 is equal to 2e over h bar omega, and this implies that E or 2E is h bar omega, and if I take 2 is common from here, then this is n plus half. So 2 are cancelled here, and we are left with E equals n plus half h bar omega. And this is the previous relation for the energy of the nth state. So we have recovered our energy of the maximum state here, the nth state here, that we solved with the help of the algebraic equation as well, where we have n equals 0. When n is 0, we are having half h bar omega, which is the 0 point energy.